Hey guys, welcome back to Vince Vail Custom. So today we're going to do a garage kit review on a 1/6 scale Savage Land Road kit that was sculpted by Sean Kyle. I don't know if he's the one who produced it, I have no clue, but somebody contacted me a while back and they really wanted to get this kit painted up with some other stuff I'm working on for them. So I figured it's a good time to pop the kit out now, do a review, and start prepping up before the cold weather hits. We're at the fall now, so I try to plan this year where I could get a lot of kits ready to go before the winter time hits and I don't have to go in and out of the garage customizing in the cold. I can stay in a warm studio and do a lot more paint work and stuff. So just trying to plan things out. So I figured let me pop this out. We'll kind of go over it and show you what's going on. I'm doing this in the garage only because I got some better lighting for yellow resin. I don't know what company or what kind of resin this is. There's tons of different resin companies out there, but more like maybe the lesser brand name resins out there is usually like yellow like this, where if you get like smooth on resin, it's usually pure white out of the bottle when you mix them together. But usually I put like a dye, or most people put like a drop of black dye or green dye, and you get that colored resin. But I mean, it's all the same. It doesn't really matter. Those are just dye. So, but it's a little bit easier to see in here in the garage. So we have the base, we have the hair, we have the body, we have the leg, we got a couple, I guess either tusks or rib cage. I'm not really sure what they're supposed to be yet. We have the hand holding up the wooden staff, and then we have the other arm. So we'll go on to the main body. So you can see the main body here. I think sculpted really cool. You know, I'm always looking at 1/6 scale now, and I'm always saying, you know, these things are small, but when I first got into the hobby, working on something like a 1/6 was like large compared to what things are now. 1/4, 1/3, they're just crazy sizes now. But I mean, sculpted really good. It's you got your typical flashing on a kit, you know, you got your line going across here because I guess it's a two-part mold, and you got your other line going over here. You know, I got a little bit of messiness underneath here, but that's nothing. I'm so used to stuff by now. I look at it and be like, ah, it's no big deal. It's a typical kit. I mean, just like when you get something and it's split like really bad here, like the mold wasn't actually lined up and then you have to rebuild the whole leg of muscle, those are usually a pain. But when you have something like this, it's just a matter of throwing primer on there, grab some putty, sand it down, and you're ready to go. You just got to clean up a little bit underneath, you know, the hands, probably around the boot areas, within the cuff area around here, and stuff like that. Really good face sculpt. I like the wrinkles in the shirt. Definitely feels like, you know, it came out from the comics. I guess it's definitely bone scale, so it looks pretty good. So you got like the left foot here, and how that goes on. So that's gonna be a little bit tricky. You gotta kinda, it's not like the perfect keying, but it's still a decent key. It's just a matter of hitting the Dremel, cleaning this up, and attaching it, and then you got, you know, a wrap around her leg, so that's kind of a good keying spot, you know. So I had to clean that up. And then just looking at her when she goes on to the base, let's see, this is how she's gonna go. She's a little bit oily, I guess, for a mold release, so I got to do all my cleaning and stuff, so you can kind of see how she sits into the base like so. So looking at the way this is, just, you know, off the top of my head, what I'm thinking, I'm probably gonna have to do maybe a peg here on this foot, and then a magnet here, because there's not a lot of meat at the bottom of this for a peg, and there's no really room for a rod to go into here. But there's a little bit more of a rod over here, so what I'll do is I'll put a nice good metal thick rod into this leg, and then what I'll do is I'll put one here, so this way she'll slide into this part of the base, and then her over here will probably be a magnet, so this way she stays in the base, because I want to make her removable because of shipping. Plus, you know, I always tell people when I try to do kits for them, it's easier for me to do it in certain pieces as a build up, and then it's also easier to ship it back. Plus, I understand as collectors, sometimes you gotta pack and move, sometimes you gotta sell your collection. So if this was all one solid piece with all these things sticking out, it'd be a nightmare to kinda, you know, pack it up. So that's pretty much where we're at that. Now, one of the other things too is her arm goes like this. And the reason why they did this on the kit is because if you were to make a mold with this arm here and you have this little bit of a circle, it's a nightmare to make a mold in between here. And even if it's a two-piece mold, it probably could work, but the way this is kind of sculpted and all the way these curves are, it would probably just be a nightmare plus to make the mold and to clean it up as a kit builder. So what they did is they did the smart thing and they cut this. So for me, it's as simple as cutting a hole here and here and attaching it with some A's and seaming it up, and then I could paint it my way. So that's not a problem, but it's, you know, that's what you got to do when you make molds and stuff. But Other than that, we got the arm here with the staff. I have to figure out the position. I think it's more like this or something. So this will probably definitely be like, I'll put a rod in here and another rod with a magnet over here. So this could kind of come in and out. Plus it'll be a little bit easier to paint up too, because if you attach it and then you try to paint all this up, and then because this is kind of, probably there's no metal rod in here and this is only resin, you could kind of snap it too. So gotta be careful of that. As far as her hair, this is the way her hair goes. Now it may look a little bit weird on her forehead only because over here, this piece will go as her headband like so. So I have to figure that out and get that cleaned up and make sure we're going there. One of the things too is when I pull this out of the box, you see this little piece on the hair. That's where they put the mold into the hair. So I have to kind of drumble this off and then re-sculpt those hair pieces like so. All this messiness under here doesn't really matter because it's going to be behind the head anyway. So even when you see kits and you see stuff like that, if it's hidden, it's not a big deal. Over here, you know, as far as the, you got some headbands and some sash. I don't know where these go. I have to look at the kit. I'm not sure if it goes on, you know, I was thinking it would go on here, like one of these spots. And I also thought it would go on a hair, but I have to look at the picture again. But you can see the way this is kind of cast up. If you ever see those like model car kits, I don't know if you ever built like motorcycles and model kits as a kid, and they have the, you know, the wireframe and the pieces you got to cut out. It's like the same thing. I guess it's like, you know, forced injection or a pressure mold. So it's probably a two-piece mold like so, and they pour it in, and then when you split the mold, you got your pieces like so. So that's kind of cool. I really don't see a lot of stuff casted up this way. Usually it's always just a little piece. They probably cut it off. I mean, they probably do cast it, but when I get the parts in the mail, usually you always get the little extra flashing part, but you never really get this piece. So it's kind of a cool way. Here's the base on the bottom. I don't know if this came with a sticker or a plaque. So it's got like a square at the bottom. They probably did this for a couple of reasons. One, to save on room, and maybe two, to kind of sign it or maybe have kind of sticker. I don't really know. I wasn't sent any of that. But the base is done pretty good. Nice little simple rock base. So these right here are horns or tusks or rib cages. I'm not really sure what they are. I'm not sure how we're going to paint it up yet. So I'm thinking the way this is going to work is, you know, these go into the bases, certain areas like so. There's a couple other holes here and there and stuff like that. So they would go around the base like so. Not really sure if I'm going to do these with magnets or if I'm going to do them with pegs. I have to see how it's set up. So I'm thinking if I attach these onto the base and they're secured and she's not attached to the base, this can actually be packed pretty well because you could put like foam and bubble wrap between the tusks and around the tusks and it'll go shipped pretty fine. So I got to kind of toy with that idea. But other than that, that's the 1/6 scale Savage Land Rogue. Pretty well done, simple kit, straightforward. It's just a matter of cleaning it up and prepping it and then the paint work. You know, it's not as much paint work as you might think. It's more prep work than anything. That's typical with a lot of kits. So thanks for watching, and hopefully this will be done in, you know, maybe a month or two. And we'll be back with some more videos.